Good day, dear students. Welcome back. As I was discussing classification of animal kingdom, wherein I have already told you some of the phyla of animal kingdom, and today we are going to discuss the next phylum of animal kingdom. The phylum is Ashtelmintis. Okay. Now, as I was telling you some of the peculiar characteristics or common names of organisms belonging to Platyhelminthes, Porifera, then Ctenophora, like that, here also the organisms are commonly called as roundworms. Now, why they are called as roundworms? Okay. Imagine this is an organism belonging to phylum Ashtelmintis. Now, this organism is like pipes. Okay, and when I take cross section or transverse section, okay, when I want to take the transverse section or TS of this particular organism, I will be able to get circular outline, just circular outline. And because of that reason, the organisms belonging to phylum Ashtelmintis are referred as roundworms. So whenever you talk about Ashtelmintis, the first thing should come in your mind is the organisms are commonly called as roundworms. Why? Because when you take transverse section, you will be able to get circular outline. That's it. Okay. So these are some of the examples of phylum Ashtelmintis: Inquilostoma, Bucheria, Bancrofti, and Ascaris. Everyone must be familiar with the word or the term Ascaris, right? Okay. Now looking at these names itself, one can easily remember that some of these organisms are parasitic form. Everyone knows about Ascaris, right? So Ascaris is parasitic. So when you talk about their habitat, first thing will come in your mind is they are found or they are parasitic in nature. Let us see some more habits and some more features of Ashtelmintis right now. Okay. Now, as I told you, the very first feature is they are commonly called as roundworms. Second, habit. Let us discuss about their habit and habitat. Okay. Now, some are free living. Now, why I am talking about free living and parasitic form? These are the two categories. Wherein some organisms depend on other organism for nourishment, so parasitic form. And some organisms are not dependent on other organisms for their nourishment, so they are free living, we say. Okay, so organisms belonging to phylum Ashtelmintis, some are free living. Now they can either found in the water, aquatic condition, or found on the land, so terrestrial condition. Another category I told you, parasitic form. Okay, now parasitic form can be parasitic in can be in the animals. Okay, or they can be present in the animal's body for nourishment, so parasitic in plants. Or in the animal's body also. Got it? So free living in aquatic or terrestrial condition, and parasitic can be in the body of plants or in the body of other animals also, including human beings also. Okay? Now this is the phylum which has developed organ system level of organization. Okay? If I am talking about the levels of organization, phylum Porifera having cellular level of organization. Later we have discussed tissue level of organization. Phylum Platyhelminthes was the phylum that phylum was having organ level of organization, and this is the phylum where systems have developed. So they have developed organ system level of organization. Meaning some of the advanced features like advanced digestive system they have developed now, okay, circulatory system, some of the other organ systems they have developed. Okay, so this is the first phyla now in the hierarchical or in the steps, if we take example, this is the first phyla which has developed organ system. Okay, now this is the organism, I told you, pipe-like organism, circular in outline, so obviously I cannot get radial symmetry. If I cut open, if I just pass a plane from the center of the organism, I will get left and right half equal, so bilateral symmetrical. They are bilateral symmetrical. Okay, then this, from Platyhelminthes onwards, they are triploblastic now. Okay, so triploblastic meaning the body has developed from three germinal layers, that is ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. Okay, now Now, very important feature you have to remember about this organism, they are pseudocoelomate. Now, what is pseudocoelomate? I have told you this, okay? Body has developed the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm, okay? And I told you that a coelom is present between the body wall and the alimentary canal, okay? And that coelom is always lined by mesoderm. Here, coelom is lined by mesoderm since it is triploblastic. Mesoderm is there, okay? But that coelom itself is not continuous. Coelom is always in the form of pouches, okay? And that's why the organism, I cannot say they are completely or they are coelomate animals, because though they have coelom, but it is not continuously lined by mesoderm. It is found in pouches. That's why it is referred as, or these organisms are pseudocoelomate. Got it? So pseudocoelomate. This is the only file you have to remember having pseudocoelomate. Okay? Now they are pseudocoelomates. Now, as I was telling you, they have developed organ system. So let us discuss some of the organ system. The very, very first one we'll be discussing is about the digestive system. They have alimentary canal which is complete. You remember, I was telling you about this also. If alimentary canal is complete, that means the mouth and the anus are the two openings they have. Got it? So they have two separate openings, one for intake of food and one for excretion. So they have mouth as well as anus. That's why alimentary canal is complete. Apart from this mouth and anus, they have also developed one advanced feature, and that is presence of muscular pharynx. So they have developed pharynx which is somewhat having, which are lined by some muscles. So they have developed muscular pharynx also. Okay. Now, sexes are separate. Now, sexes are separate, meaning the male and female organisms are different. Male organism will have only male reproductive structure. Female organism will have female reproductive structures. Okay, so sexes are separate. Now, till now, whatever we have learned, if you remember about platyhelminthes, sexes were not separate, right? In case of Ctenophora also, we have seen sexes were not separate. But now we have moved to little higher level. So here, sexes are separate. Okay. So if I am talking about sexes are separate, I have mentioned here male Ascaris and female Ascaris. Okay. Now, clearly one can differentiate male organism and female organism. So I can say sexual dimorphism is seen over here. Now, what is sexual dimorphism? Whenever you look at an individual, you can clearly make out this is a male and this is female. In case of human beings also, we also can clearly make out who is male organism, who is female, because there is sexual dimorphism. We can differentiate by looking only that this is male and this is female. So here also some sexual dimorphism can be seen, that is, female is always longer than the male. Got it? See, female is longer than the male. So you can clearly differentiate which is female and male organism. Okay? Which is, that is, female is always longer than the male. Okay? Now, we are talking about the fertilization. Fertilization is internal. That means the organisms, the zygote is developed inside the body of the organism. So internal fertilization, or I can say fusion of gametes, are taking place inside the body of organism. Development can be direct or can be indirect. Now everyone knows till here direct. Direct meaning the young ones resemble the adult, right? And indirect meaning the young ones are always in the form of larval stages. So in between the adult form or young ones, there is larval stage in between. So indirect development. Got it? So direct and indirect development. Okay? So this is all about the phylum Ascalmanthes, wherein we have discussed some of the peculiar features, that is, they are commonly called as roundworms. Why? Because when you take the transverse section of this organism, you will get circular outline. Okay, now these are the organisms which has developed organ system level of organization. They are pseudocoelomate animals. Okay, they have not, they don't have perfect coelom. okay? So pseudocoelomid animals, they have developed digestive system with complete mouth and anus with muscular pharynx. Some of them are parasites. Sexes are not separate, and you can clearly distinguish male and female organisms. These are some of the peculiar features of this particular organisms. Okay, in the next video session, we are going to discuss the next important phyla. Thank you, everyone.